Polar Bear and Sea Lion. Time ago, thousands of people would pile onto steamships and travel to the Isle of Man on holiday. They would walk in the beautiful countryside, play on the beaches, eat Max ice cream and Max kippers, and marvel at the Max cats with no tails. There was a grand steam railway, horse-drawn carriages, and an electric tramway was soon to be built. Mr. Broadbent, who lived near Groudle Glen, knew that the tram line would go past his house.
"I shall build a hotel," he said, "and perhaps some things too."
So up went the hotel, and he filled the valley of the glen with a bowling green, a dance floor, swings, roundabouts, a photographer, fortune teller, a fair, wooden walkways, a water wheel, and hundreds of trees. Lots of people came to see it. But Mr. Broadbent didn't want to stop. He wrote to Manchester Zoo.
"Could you spare a few animals?"
"Of course we could," replied the zookeeper. "We shall send you Nelly and Jumbo too."
Before long, there were two brown bear cubs that, for a small fee, children could walk along the cliff edge. There was a bird house next to the tea room. And in the rocky caves in the cliff, there were six sea lions and two polar bears called Nelly and Jumbo. And every so often, the polar bears would look across at the sea lions and lick their lips. It was a very long walk through Groudle Glen to the zoo.
"A little railway to carry folk would help," thought Mr. Broadbent with a smile,
and he had one built, and he ordered a little engine and three carriages. The engine duly arrived.
"Your job is to take all the visitors to the zoo," explained Mr. Broadbent, "and your name is now Sea Lion."
The little loco proudly set to work. Sea Lion was very popular indeed. Very soon she was making 40 trips each day up and down the railway track full of passengers and taking seafood for the animals too. Each evening though she was very tired and sat alone in her shed.
"Dear me," said Mr. Broadbent, "I'll get an air engine to help with the work and we'll build a passing loop in the track too."
Before long, the air engine arrived.
"Look at me," he said as he chuffed into the station. "I'm Polar Bear and I have four carriages. Look at my lovely coat of paint."
Mr. Broadbent nodded approvingly. Bob, the driver, smirked and people clapped. Now, Polar Bear and Bob would work on the line all day too. And each time they passed Sea Lion at the loop, they would toot and tease Sea Lion.
Until one day,
The passengers climbed on board as usual.
Time to go, said Bob,
wearily.
Look at me, cried Polar Bear as he sped along the rails. Look at me,
he tooted as he passed Sea Lion at the loop. But Bob, the driver, didn't feel very well and sat down. As Polar Bear reached the headland, he started to go faster. Bob, the driver, closed his eyes. On and on, faster and faster he went.
Stop! Cried Polar Bear. Stop!
But Bob, the driver, didn't brake. Suddenly, bang! Went Polar Bear as he bashed into the buffers. Crash! Went the carriages as they careered into each other. The wheels slipped off the rails and the people fell out of their seats. Poor Bob had had a nasty turn. Everybody came rushing to help. Quick, call for Sea Lion, they cried. And she quickly came chuffing up the track. The injured people were lifted into her three carriages.
Oh dear, oh no, I'm stuck,
boned Polar Bear.
Let me help you too, said Sea Lion.
And she towed the poor broken engine back onto the rails and all the way back to the shed. Polar Bear could no longer work. His frames were bent and his wheels were buckled.
Oh dear, said Mr. Broadbent. You'll have to go away to be fixed and see Lion could do all the work until we saw you out. So off he went.
Now Sea Lion started to take the people to see the animals all on her own again, but she secretly missed silly, arrogant Polar Bear. A few weeks later he was back, but he wasn't the same Polar Bear.
Thank you for helping me,
he said sheepishly.
Time for you to pick up your passengers, said Mr. Broadbent.
I don't think I can,
said Polar Bear.
Don't be scared, said Sea Lion. I'll be beside you.
Then the two engines set off to pick up the passengers. They slowly chuffed out the shed. Polar Bear was so happy. Everybody cheered to see Polar Bear and Sea Lion working together again.